Hey everybody on YouTube. Today I thought I'd take out a moment to do another vintage video repair, or basically this is going to be a progress report. I'm pretty much going to walk through the steps on this particular machine that I've been working on from a museum. There's a lot of issues with this machine, so I'm trying to do it step by step so the people who are out there who are interested in this machine will have a good idea how difficult it is to fix a machine such as this. This is a progress report on the Sanyo VTC7100. I received three of these machines. All three machines were suffering severe problems, missing parts, you name it. Well, I've gotten pretty far in this machine, and I just wanted to point out some things so people can get a good idea. When you do vintage video repairs, sometimes you really have to check everything and fix things you didn't normally have to fix. All right, I want to point out, well, of course, this is the a picture that I got up there of, this is the systems board on the back of the machine. All right. There's a board on the right of the machine which controls your video playback, your video heads, and such and such and such. But this particular board controls all the functions of the machine, in the record position, the slow position, the rewind, fast forward, the motor mechanisms. And this is the most problematic board of it all, of everything, really. I just got done putting brand new capacitors on this board, and basically on the other board as well. I had it running earlier. We now get good audio coming through the machine. It records audio and it plays back audio. But now we're at the point where the motors are spinning too fast. So I troubleshooted all that, and we have these. Amplifier ICs, which are located towards the back where it plugs in, that runs the capstan motor, which also trails to the actual servo motor itself. They have to be in sync with each other. Well, this little section I'm working on now, these are ICs that work to maintain the speed of the actual unit. And they're getting very hot, meaning they're faulty. I've noticed the reason, and now I know why this machine has failed anybody who's actually had one of these. These IC chips need to have what's called heat sinks. They have absolutely no heat sinks on these ICs. And I noticed this IC chip gets very, very, very hot without a IC sink to dissipate the heat from that IC or that chip. It will fail sooner or later. Well, I think that's what the problem is. I think these IC chips are—they're actually transistors—they're actually starting to fail because they're getting too hot, and the tolerances are way out of whack. So I've got some parts on order to start diving into the motor run problem with getting the speeds to come back to where they belong. I mean, I'll try to record, it records in slow, I try to play that audio back, and it just flies through the machine. So it is definitely a motor speed function problem, which is what I'm working on right now. And of course, I just got done recapping the entire board. Also, I've noticed on this machine, I fixed an awful lot of stuff. Springs, guides, you name it. But also, it's kind of funny because you have these little switches in the back of this unit that many people wouldn't even think about fixing. I had brand new ones to replace these with, thank God, because these are kind of hard to find, these switches. But they were bad. So I ended up changing all those switches in the back, which is in the back of the unit. And there's also a couple of them hidden up at the very top. It's a very little micro switch that has a little lever on it. I had a whole tray of about 20 of these. Very lucky I had these. I did not have to search for these. I got these for free many years ago. So I was glad I was able to use a few of these for a change. But they are really cool little switches. On top of it, I was checking all the connectors. And all the connectors I was cleaning, they were seriously corroded from, because they have silver, they're actually silver pins, they're like silver dipped. So I had to go in there and clean them with the famous stuff called deoxit, and clean all the connections. Sometimes that will cause issues with problems connected to circuit boards. But I'm making a lot of progress on this machine. I just wanted to point out to people, the phase of this machine we're at right now is we do get audio coming into the unit. We do get it to actually record audio. It's the motor function is not working properly. It is playing the audio very, very fast. I have not gotten to the stage of video yet. I did convert the plug that plugs into the side of this thing because they gave me a cable for it, but it plugs, it's actually, when you used to have an EIJ TV set, you'd plug a big plug into the TV and then you plug the small round one into the side of this. Well, for a favor for this company, I converted that plug custom, so they have RCA plugs on the end of that, input and output, so they don't have to worry trying to, if they want to do a tape conversion and... Because if you don't have an EIJ TV to plug it in and all that crap, it's a real pain in the butt. So I made it RCA connection user-friendly for the company who's going to receive this deck. But anyways, making an awful lot of progress. Changed a lot of switches. Got audio going in and out of this unit. Changed all the belts. Put brand new belts on this unit. It's come a long way. So, like I said, this is for the Sanyo VTC 7100, a very, very difficult machine to work on. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video.